Modern weather records only stretch back about 150 years. But how do researchers reconstruct ancient temperatures on Earth from millions of years ago? The answer lies in climate proxies, natural archives that provide clues to past climatic conditions. Today, we can instantly check temperatures on our phones, but ancient thermometer readings don't exist. To estimate prehistoric heat and cold, scientists rely on preserved physical evidence that correlates with the planet's climate. Ice sheets in places like Greenland and Antarctica provide a priceless window into the past. Each year, a new layer of snow is added, effectively burying a snapshot of that year's climate. Researchers can drill deep cores that reveal hundreds of thousands of years of layered ice. The chemistry of each layer varies depending on the temperature when it formed. Isotope ratios differ, for example, allowing the reconstruction of year-to-year temperature changes going back eons. Tiny air bubbles trapped in the ice also reveal the atmospheric gas composition at any given time. Tree rings preserve climatic evidence too. Rings tend to be thicker in warmer years with adequate rain, and thinner in cold or dry years. By finding very old, dead trees, rings can be analyzed going back thousands of years. In some cases, overlapping tree rings from living and dead specimens let researchers build a climatic sequence reaching back over 10,000 years. Fossilized pollen grains also act as a temperature proxy. Different plant species produce different pollen based on climate conditions. By examining sediment samples for pollen types and concentrations, a picture emerges of what regional vegetation and temperatures were like. Scientists similarly use fossilized plant leaves to deduce ancient carbon dioxide levels, which influence temperature. Leaf pores, called stomata, open and close based on CO2 levels. More pores point to higher prehistoric CO2 levels. At lake bottoms and on the sea floor, surface organism shells accumulate in sediment over the eons. The oxygen isotopes in these shells correlate to water temperatures when they were alive. Sediment core samples allow scientists to probe back millions of years. No single proxy method provides perfect accuracy, but by overlapping multiple natural archives, the temperature patterns of the past come into sharper focus. Though indirect, proxies help fill the enormous gaps in our planet's climate history that instruments alone cannot achieve. They show how much global temperatures have changed over Earth's history. Today's warming may seem rapid for a human lifetime, but proxies give a broader perspective, showing how briefly humans have been in Earth's story. Our existence occupies only a tiny sliver of climatic time. While the future is hard to predict, the past teaches that change is nature's only constant. The planet will continue evolving, with or without us.